Hi, I'm Carolyn Coffin. I'm a sonographer and an ultrasound educator. And for the past 14 years, I've been at Seattle University as the chair of their ultrasound program and now as an adjunct professor. I also am co-owner of Sound Ergonomics, which is an ergonomic consulting firm focusing on occupational injury in medical imagers. I also work with Summit Imaging, helping educate their engineers and technical support staff in sonographers' needs. What do we need to see in an image? What makes an image diagnostic? And what are the things that go wrong in an image, and how do sonographers explain that to the repair group? So today we're going to talk about Doppler, color and pulsed, and just a little bit about the things that can go wrong and the things that we look for as sonographers that help us do good patient imaging. We're going to start with this image. The first thing that I want to point out here is this happens to be the carotid artery, and we're using a Philips EPIC system with a linear transducer, the AL12-5. This is the head of the patient and the feet. This is the common carotid artery and its length. The important thing about this image is what we can see right here. This is the wall of the carotid artery, and it's important that the transducer give us the resolution we need to get that thickness to be able to measure that. It's very important diagnostic criteria for carotid artery disease. The other thing about this image that would be a problem for a sonographer, and I created it to demonstrate this, is the gray here and here. We don't want a black vessel, a blood-filled vessel, to have gray in the image anywhere. So is that a transducer issue or is it a sonographer issue? When the sonographer has done everything he or she can to clear this out, then it falls to the technical support team to determine if it's a transducer issue. So we're going to look at this in real time. And you can see how clear we can see the wall of the artery, the internal wall of the artery, which is really important to sonographers. It's important that the transducer components, even though they might not know this, but the transducer components have to be the best they can be. Now we have color Doppler, and this is showing blood flow in the carotid toward the head of the patient. What we want to see is a completely filled vessel. We definitely don't want any areas where there's no color, because that could be a filling defect related to plaque or some kind of arterial pathology. We want the color. We're going to stop it right here and back it up just a little. We want the color to be predominantly the main color, which in this case is red, but occasionally it's going to have some higher velocities in it, and that's okay because of the heartbeat, which forces blood at a faster speed. So we want to make sure that it's filled and that it's the appropriate color and that there's no dropout areas where there's like a line with no color, or a line where the color comes all the way through the soft tissue. That indicates a crystal issue. And so let's see what happens when we forward it to the pulse Doppler. So this is pulse Doppler, and this is how we want our image to look. We want the background to be black, and we want the inside of the artery or the peak to be black as well. Now in this image, if we stop right there, you can see that there are echoes in here, and that is not desirable. Sometimes it's a sonographer issue, and once the sonographer has done everything possible to eliminate these echoes, then we worry that there's a transducer problem. So this should be black, and it should be black inside here when you're looking at a large vessel. So let's look at it a little bit more. This is nice color fill. This is too many echoes. So it's important that the transducer have all the crystals appropriately working so that we get good color fill and we get good, clean Doppler peaks. They're important components of a diagnostic exam. And the transducer is an important component of the exam. You can see here that there's some dropout created by me right there. And I created that. That would happen if there was missing crystals or a broken component of the transducer. So the important thing is the transducer have high quality components and not have remanufactured components. So all the technical staff and engineers at Summit Imaging have worked with me on how they understand the image to look, and they've done a good job learning how to talk to the sonographers and how to speak their language. So hopefully you learned a little bit more about Doppler and what we look for as sonographers, and I'd like to thank you for attending. Bye.